Hey, it's a beautiful 54 degrees. It's December 9th. The question today, as I enjoy this walk, is what are you striving for? So this is Walk and Talk number 87, and we are focused on expectations. So what are you expecting? Life goes every day. Work, family, marriage. Enjoy a breakfast or lunch or dinner or a vacation. What are you expecting? There are positive expectations and discouraging expectations. So we're in Philippians chapter 3, verse 20. We'll look at two verses, Philippians 3, 20 and 21. And I'm going to remind you of four godly expectations. A good chance, if you're not focused on these four healthy, good expectations, you're probably discouraged. You're probably challenged emotionally, mentally. So Philippians chapter 3, verse 20 says, "For our citizenship is in heaven." Now that's expectation number one. Expect heaven. It's an amazing statement, isn't it? And it's really not just in Philippians 3:20. But you'll find the concept. Jesus taught the reality of heaven. Throughout the Bible, there's plenty of factual evidence of heaven. And the question becomes, do you expect heaven? For our citizenship is in heaven. So, not earth. So lots of us are earthbound, earth-focused, and this is just simply saying, hey, your home is in heaven for our citizenship. That's your primary community. Your legal residence is not earth. It's not Phoenix, Arizona, or Tempe, or Mesa, or wherever you may live. It's heaven. Heaven is where God is. Yes, God is everywhere, but there is a place God has created where the throne of God is found in heaven. I wish I could tell you exactly scientifically where it's at. I don't have that ability. The Bible explains heaven as the place where there's no sin. Angels who are submissive to God, Jesus Christ, the Holy Spirit. There's no brokenness in heaven. There's no conflict in heaven. Everyone bows, everyone worships, everyone cooperates. There's no left, right, Democrat, Republican. There's no rebellion. There's no terrorist. There is no conflict. It's peace. So heaven is your legal residence. It's your primary community. It's your home. For our citizenship is in heaven. So expectations is for the individual Christian. You should not focus on earth because earth is temporary. The book of Revelations, Jesus taught the earth would be dissolved at some point. There'd be a new heavens and a new earth. So God did not prepare you for earth eternally. He prepared you for heaven eternally. So can you expect, as you live your life day by day, heaven? because God has legally declared you a citizen of heaven. The Bible says that Jesus Christ purchased your citizenship by his death, burial, and resurrection. You are a legal citizen of heaven. You have not arrived yet, but there will be a day when you will experience no personal sin, eternity serving God, worshiping him, honoring him, for he is worthy. The Bible says in Philippians chapter 3, verse 20, for our citizenship is in heaven, now watch this, from which we also eagerly wait for a Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ. So, what's your expectations on earth? You should be expecting heaven, and you should expect Jesus Christ. You should anticipate the return of Jesus Christ, from which we also eagerly wait. Get this. Put the two words together, eagerly wait. Eager is hope. Eager is joy. And eagerly waiting is joyful looking. You're expecting joyfully Jesus Christ is going to return. And the Bible says he can return literally like a thief in the night. You don't know when the thief will strike. But the Bible clearly says that Jesus is coming back, and he will literally radically change things. So we also eagerly wait for a Savior. So are you expecting Jesus today? How about that? How about tomorrow? How about, are you expecting Jesus next week? And it's the idea of eagerly expecting, joyfully expecting. See, you belong in heaven, not earth. Earth is temporary, and Jesus is going to take you there. Jesus is God. By his death, burial, and resurrection, he purchased your admission into heaven, your citizenship. You by faith alone, not by any of your works, but by faith alone, by grace alone in Jesus. Jesus died on a cross, so you have the privilege, you have that privilege of expecting salvation. Salvation from earth, salvation from death, salvation from hell, and you're bound for heaven because of your Savior. He is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. He is the eternal now. So, listen, Jesus is not an event. He's a person. We eagerly wait, according to Philippians 3:20. We eagerly wait for our Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ. He is a person. So you have the privilege of loving a person, of loving a Savior, not an event. Heaven is not an event. It's a destination. It's a destiny. Jesus as your Savior is not some fickle, temporary event. He's a person, God. This type of expecting is completely difficult to wrap your head around. Have you ever heard the term psychosomatic? Psychosomatic. Psyche refers to the mind, and soma refers to the body. Now get this, psychosomatic. So lots of things that we think about in our mind affect our bodies. If in your mind you're worrying yourself, quote, sick, people get ulcers, high blood pressure, people become depressed. People become panic. People become filled with anxiety because of the psychological focus of wrong things in their mind. So a psychosomatic individual has expectations that are unhealthy. Why not trade unhealthy, ungodly, bad expectations for heaven? Why not trade the fickleness of earth for Jesus? See, we've got to back up and evaluate, what are we thinking? What are our thoughts? What are we hoping for? So the challenge is, do you hope? Do you long for Jesus? Do you hope? Do you long for heaven? So Philippians chapter 3, verse 20 says, our citizenship is in heaven, from which we also eagerly wait for a Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus will return to earth. He comes from heaven. And literally, look, get this. Here's the third expectation. So first, every day you should be expecting heaven, and every day you should be expecting Jesus. And number three, you should expect a new body. Look at verse 21, Philippians 3:21. It says, Jesus will transform the body of our lowly condition into conformity with his glorious body by the exertion of the power that he has even to subject all things to himself. You just received the promise of a resurrected body. You just received the promise of a glorified body. You just received the promise, based upon Scripture, that Jesus Christ will morph, will transform your physical body, literally, into a body like the resurrected body of Jesus. Now, that's not saying you will become godlike. It's just simply saying Jesus was able to eat after his resurrection, right? He ate fish with his disciples on the shore of Galilee. Isn't it interesting that he was able to appear miraculously through walls, the upper room after the resurrection? There will be no sin in your body. There will be no aches. There will be no pain. The resurrected body, it's amazing. It's called a glorious body here in Philippians chapter 3, verse 21. So what's your body like today? My guess is you're like everybody. You have probably something wrong with different parts. Maybe you have a hip or a knee, or maybe you have an arm, maybe skin cancer. I just got a text message about 35 minutes ago, someone saying, pray for my husband. He has COVID and was just last night taken to ICU. Imagine a glorious resurrected body where disease and sickness cannot touch you. Can you imagine no vaccinations in heaven? Can you imagine no need for surgeons in heaven? No need for a cancer doctor? I have two or three times a year a skin checkup for skin cancer. Can you imagine no lung cancer or Maybe you're diabetic. Maybe you have a insulin pump. Maybe you can't walk. Maybe you have you're blind. Can you imagine no physical deficiencies in heaven? You will have a resurrected body. It says there in verse 21 that Jesus will transform the body of our lowly condition into conformity, watch this, with his glorious body. So can you expect a heavenly body? Sure. I'm suggesting to you that what you expect, what you strive for, what you hope for, could help you or hurt you. And the Bible is saying you can expect heaven. You belong there. The Bible is saying in Philippians chapter 3, verse 20, that you can expect Jesus Christ. He's coming back. And you can expect a new body. Imagine a body that never wears out. There's no transplants. There's no doctor appointments. Those of you who take medicine every day, there's no pills in heaven. Imagine never going to a doctor again. You don't have to make any doctor appointments. Imagine being able to eat bacon and eggs and fried potatoes, sausage, pork chops, pancakes. Imagine eating French toast and just smother it with butter and maple syrup or boysenberry or raspberry or strawberry syrup. Pile on the whipped cream. Imagine it. Heaven. Guess what? There's no digestive problems in heaven. There's no physical limitation as we think on earth. You don't have to have food to have energy. It's pretty amazing when you think about this glorious body. Philippians chapter 3, verse 21 says, how does all this occur? How can you expect heaven? How can you expect Jesus Christ? Well, verse 21 says, the last phrase, that by the exertion of the power that Jesus has, even to subject all things to himself. Now, do you see what the fourth expectation is? How about expect Jesus to have unlimited power and authority? Or put it another way, expect Jesus to be sovereign. Lots of us struggle with the sovereignty of God on earth. God doesn't struggle with that. And when you get to heaven, you will not struggle with the sovereignty of God. All things work together for good to those who love God and are called according to his purpose. These are expectations that psychologically, psychosomatic, will make you healthier. So I'm just simply suggesting there are good expectations and bad expectations. And Philippians chapter 3, verse 20 to 21 gives you at least four amazing expectations. Number one, you belong in heaven. Expect it. You belong in heaven because of your Savior, Jesus Christ, not because you're a Savior. And number three, you will receive a glorious new body. Expect it. And expect to worship Jesus, who is sovereign, who has unlimited power and authority. We often have a difficult time seeing on earth Jesus as being sovereign. When we look at the brokenness of the world, we just can't possibly understand why bad things happen, why God would allow the brokenness of this world. And the simple answer is, it's the consequences of man's bad choices. It's the consequences of the foolishness of mankind that we have the brokenness of the world. God did not create, start it that way. He started humanity in a perfect condition with a free will. And Adam and Eve chose not. They expected to follow Satan's advice, which would be basically, you know, God doesn't have boundaries, so go do whatever you want. And then there were consequences. I'm gently saying to you, your home is in heaven. Jesus is coming back. Jesus promises a new body for you, physical body for you, even though in heaven it will be more of a spiritual body, but your physical will be transformed into a resurrected body, and you will worship a sovereign Jesus Christ with the full meaning of that. His ability makes everything happen by his choice. It's amazing, isn't it? What are you striving for? Every day, you're striving for something politically? Are you striving for getting rich? Are you striving for, let's just say, reducing weight? What are you expecting? Are you expecting no conflict in your family, no conflict in your marriage? Are you expecting people to figure it out? Are you expecting people to be kind? Are you can expect a lot of things. I'm gently saying to you, these are four expectations. Every day, expect heaven. You belong there. Expect your Savior Jesus to return. Expect a new body in heaven. And expect the unlimited power and authority of Jesus Christ. He's God. Put these expectations right in the center, right in the core of your mind and your heart. It's amazing, isn't it? It doesn't matter what happens on earth, whether there's a buildup of another country wanting to invade another country, or whether it's the rise of sickness, or whether it's people doing the most hurtful things to each other. You, as a Christian, need to expect four things every day. Expect heaven. Your legal residence is in heaven. Expect Jesus to return. It will not be an event. It'll be in person. Expect a new transformed body. And expect a sovereign Lord. These expectations have been in the Bible for 2,000 years. But really, some 2,000, 3,000, 4,000 years before that, you literally have prophecy. You literally have God telling us these things are coming. Micah chapter 5, that Jesus would be born in Bethlehem and would be the ruler. And guess what happens? Years later, Jesus is born in Bethlehem to Mary, to Joseph. This is Walk and Talk number 87. It's a wonderful day. Don't destroy your life with negative, ungodly expectations. We invite you this coming Sunday, join us for worship. We have an 8 o'clock classical traditional service with hymns, usually the organ, usually the piano. It's just a special service. 9:30, 11, we have two other services in the worship center. We lift up the Lord Jesus Christ. We have another worship service at 11 in the upper room upstairs, and at 6 p.m. This coming Sunday night at 6 p.m., we have a Christmas concert. You can sing carols, you can listen to people with sing songs by solo. You can enjoy the choir and the orchestra as they lift up several anthems. Christmas is about remembering the birth of Jesus Christ. And you know that he was not born on Christmas. He was probably born in the spring, not the middle of winter. Remember, there's sheep out in the fields at night, so it's probably more springtime. But the date that was identified to celebrate the birth of Jesus is December 25th. And that's the date that mankind has basically found a way to agree that's when we're going to celebrate the birth of Jesus. We will have cookies after our Christmas celebration this Sunday night. So join us. Remember the word psychosomatic. You can dwell on good things, and that will be good for your body. Or you can dwell on negative things and bring poison into your physical body. What are you striving for? What are you hoping for? What are you expecting will happen? I'm saying expect heaven.